Hi, my friends. Welcome to EFCLA Children Congregations. Let us come together in worship and praise.
I'm Jim, and I'm going to be bringing you a message about forgiveness today. 原谅。你们有没有在家里做错了什么事情，然后爸爸妈妈很生气，然后你会希望他们能原谅你，然后一切就像以前一样，他们原谅了以后，就 everything is good.Have you ever done anything really bad at home and your parents are really angry and you wish that they forgive you so that everything goes back to normal? Well, we're going to talk about the story of Esau forgiving his younger brother Jacob. So what happened? Well, we'll kind of talk about what happened before. Okay. Now, Esau and Jacob...has a very, very old father. Tell, he can't see anything. He has to touch, can't really hear. Okay? And so what happened is that during those days, it's a very, very important thing that the father gives the oldest son a very important gift of his blessings. So one day,Father Isaac talked to the oldest brother, Esau. This is Esau. Now, Esau is big. He's got hairy arms, okay? Really, really thick hairs. And he said to him, go hunting, prepare a really big feast for me. And after I finish the feast, I'm going to give you...my blessings, okay? And so off he goes, Esau goes hunting, okay? And So what happened was that the younger brother, Jacob, he really wants that gift. He really wants that blessing. So what does he do? He pretended to be the older brother, Esau. How does he do that? He wears a jacket full of furs. So when the old father goes and touches him, it feels like Esau's hairy arms. And so that's what he did. He stole the very important gift of his father's blessings from his older brother. 所以那个时候很重要的一个礼物就是爸爸要给最大的儿子Esau一个祝福。 OK， 那因为他的弟弟非常想要这个祝福，所以呢他就假装他是他哥哥，穿着毛毛的衣服，所以爸爸去摸他的时候以为是他哥哥以扫毛毛的手，所以就把祝福给他了，他就偷了他的哥哥 的祝福。那所以你们觉得以扫会什么感觉呢？他回来了，他就非常非常的难过，也非常非常的生气。这是一个最大最大的礼物，居然被他弟弟雅各去偷走了。 OK， 你看他很难过，他刚刚打猎回来发现了，他就很难过。 He's really sad. So what happened was Jacob knows that Esau is really angry, so he ran away really far away so that he's afraid that his brother would like be so angry that he would just kill him. Okay, so he ran away. So many, many, many years later, they've all grown up. They all have kids. They marry and they have kids. And one day, God told Jacob to go back home. Okay, to go back to Esau. Okay.And so Jacob packed up his things, okay? And you can see here, he brought lots of goats, lots of sheep, lots of donkeys. These are cows, camels, his whole family, and lots of helpers for their family, okay? 所以很多年以后，因为那个时候雅各不是跑很远，因为他怕他哥哥太生气了就想要害他嘛，所以他就跑很远。那他们也都长大了，有小孩，有很 big family。 然后有一天上帝就跟他说，你要回去找你哥哥。所以他就把他的所有的东西，有山羊，有绵羊，有驴子，有牛，有骆驼，还有他的 family，他的家人回去。可是他心里在想什么呢？哇，我哥哥那个时候这么生气，我现在回去找他，他一定会想要很生气，想要害我。 OK, so when they got close, what happened was Jacob sent helpers, okay, sent his helpers to go tell EsauThat he's coming back. So the helper went and came back. And he said, yes, I told your brother that you're coming back. And he's coming out to meet you with 400 men. Okay. And so Jacob was really worried because he knew that his brother was actually very, very mad at him and may still be very mad. Okay. So he...那个时候弟弟雅各就派人去跟他哥哥说，我要回来了。然后那个人回来以后，他就说 OK, 我跟你哥哥讲了，说我你雅各我要回来了，那你哥哥呢也要出来找你。 他找了400个人要来找你，所以雅各就很担心。OK，and he prayed to God. Okay, he was really worried that his brother Esau was gonna come hurt him, and with the army of 400 people. So he prayed to God to give forgiveness, and hopefully, his brother will not hurt his family. Okay, and so, what happened was he was thinking, okay, maybe I could just send gifts. So he sent sheep, he sent goats, he sent donkeys, and he sent cows and camels ahead so that maybe his brother would see all these gifts and would just be happy and forget everything. Okay? And so, 雅各呢？这个弟弟他还是很担心，说哥哥会来伤害他，会来报仇，所以他就送了很多的羊、很多的驴子、很多的牛跟很多的骆驼，在前面，所以他哥哥说不定看到这些这么多礼物就很开心，就不会再害他。OK，那他知道说已经很近了，所以呢。他就走到前面去，他远远的看到他哥哥走过来了，OK，所以他就跑，从后面跑到前面来，OK，and so from far away, Jacob saw his brother Esau with 400 men coming. So he ran to the front, and what did he do? He knelt down before his brother to show that he was sorry. To show that he was ashamed, okay? 所以他跑到前面去，他就跪下来跟他哥哥，让他哥哥知道说他知道他是错了，okay? 然后呢，他还是不知道，会怎么样，so he still doesn't know what's gonna happen. And what happened was, his brother came over. You see him with a big smile, okay? So he actually forgave him, okay? Because the Bible says we have to forgive each other, okay? And even, you know, we have to be kind to people, even if they're not kind to you, okay? And so what happened was that Jacob showed that he was really sorry, and Esau, with his 400 men, didn't really want to come hurt him. They actually hugged each other. And they made up, okay, oops, and they made up just like God asked us to forgive each other, okay? 所以，以扫也就原谅了他的弟弟，虽然以前他偷了他这么大的礼物，偷了他这么大的祝福，但是他还是原谅了他的弟弟。他没有再生气，因为圣经里面上帝有跟我们说，我们要原谅别人，不管他们做了什么事情，对你做了什么事情，OK，All right，and so let's pray. Dear God, we give thanks because you are in our life. We give thanks. Because you let us have a good life. We thank you for the teaching today of forgiveness and let us live our lives just like you taught us to forgive others no matter what they do. Don't hold a grudge, just do what you teach us to forgive one another. Thank you, and in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.